Good morning to all. Today again we are starting with types of adjectives, and the fourth one is demonstrative adjectives. Demonstrative adjectives are used to indicate. Indicate means to show or point out a noun or a pronoun in a sentence. The four demonstrative adjectives can be this, that, these, and those. For example, this car is broken. This chair is broken. That car is expensive. These clothes are wet. Those birds are flying south. So in these examples, you can see that I have colored this, that, these, and those. And after them, nouns are there like chair, car, clothes, and birds. Now let's see why they are placed like this. So now you can see that this is used with singular noun and if the object is near. That is used with singular noun if the object is far. These with plural if object is near. Those plural if object is far. And when you want to find demonstrative adjective in a sentence, we can put a question which, like which car is broken? This car is broken. Which car is expensive? That car is expensive. Means this we are pointing for the near object and that we are pointing for far objects. Again, which clothes are wet? These clothes are wet. Which birds are flying south? Those birds are flying south. So that and those means the objects are far. This and these means the objects are near. Next is interrogative adjectives. With the word we can understand that the sentence will end with a question mark. And these adjectives help us to find what answers to the questions people ask. Like they are also used along with nouns to ask questions such as where, who, how, why, and which. And such words are words that determine the sentence completely. They make the sentence complete in terms of questioning. Means they change the sentence into question form. Now you can see the examples. Whose pen will they bring to you? Which book will they give you? Which notebook will they show you? What's your answer? What kind of plan did you create? What a delicious taste of this apple. Who is this dress for? So such words which are starting with WH. Generally, interrogative words are starting with WH. Next is possessive adjectives. The definition is possessive adjective is the adjective which is used to point out the noun that belongs to someone. Possessive means ownership, belonging to anybody. And they are seven, like my, your, our, their, his, her, and its. Now example, this is my book. So who is the owner of the book? I am the owner. Your car is outside. Whose car? Your car. It means this car is belonging to you. Now, possessive adjectives, my, yours, his, her, its. They are used if the possessor is singular. Possessor means a person who owns something, who is owning. Our, your, and there are used if the possessor is plural. Now there is no problem if the thing possessed, if the thing is owned, is singular or plural. His is masculine, her is feminine. This we have already learned in gender, okay? My, your, our, their, they are used for masculine or feminine. It is used for neuter gender. And when it is singular, there is used for neuter gender, plural. Neuter gender means neither it is masculine nor it is feminine. Generally used for non-living things. Next is distributive adjective. Sometimes in class also teachers tell you distribute the books. It means you are distributing the books to each and every student of your class. So, distributive adjectives are normally used with singular nouns. They include each, every, either, neither, and are used to refer. Refer means to point to members of a group as individuals. Individuals means single. Example, each boy must take his turn. Every man must do his duty. Either you do this or I'll be doing it. Neither of us can dance tonight. Now let us understand each, every, either and neither. Now see, each is used means it is telling every single one of a group used to speak about group members individually. Individually means one by one. Every means every single one of a group, and it is used to make generalizations. It means to make general statements. Either means one between a choice of two. Two are there and you have to choose one. Like either you do maths work or you do English work. So there is a choice between two subjects. Neither means not one or the other between a choice of two. Next is proper adjectives. So this is also a type of descriptive adjectives because they are also describing noun and they come from proper nouns. This means that they must always be with capital letter, or we can say they must be capitalized. Now, proper adjectives sometimes are formed by adding a suffix to the proper noun. And the suffix can be an, ian, n, ese, and ish. For example, you can see proper nouns and proper adjectives. China. China is becoming Chinese. Jamaica, Jamaicans. England, English. Africa, African. So when I add ese to China, it is becoming Chinese. Like if I say Chinese pots, it means what kind of pots? They are Chinese pots. England is becoming English. If I say Englishman, it means the man is English. If I say African elephants, means the elephants are African. This is telling the quality of noun. Now, again, one more important thing. As we studied adjectives, I told you that in some sentences, adjectives are at first position, and in some sentences, adjectives are in second position. So this is called the attributive use or the predicative use. Now, when the adjective is at the first position, it means if it is before noun, then we can say that the adjective is of attributive use. Like, this is an interesting story. These are ripe mangoes and so on. So interesting and ripe, they are adjectives and they are describing story and mangoes. Second, in the predicative case, you can see the noun is placed at first position. Story, mangoes, grapes, soldier, sagar. And the adjective is placed after the noun. But between the noun and adjective, there is one more thing. What it is? It is a verb. You can see here, the story is interesting. These mangoes are ripe. Those grapes are sour. These soldiers are brave. Sagar is intelligent. So those adjectives which are placed at the first position just before the noun, they are called attributive. And those which are placed after the noun, they are called predicative. Now, predicative adjectives do not occur immediately. They do not come at once after the noun. Instead, they follow a verb. You can see everywhere the adjectives in the predicative case are following a verb. So this is a kind of use of adjective, which can be attributive use also, which can be predicative use also. Now I'll just stop sharing my screen and now I can ask questions also and you can also ask me. Swati ma'am, I'll just put you on. I'll just unmute. Was it okay, ma'am?
Absolutely okay, ma'am.
Okay. Muskan Kathat, I think you are lying down on your bed. Muskan Kathat, this is a class. And yesterday also I told you, you should not lie down on your bed. Sit on a chair and keep your mobiles or laptops on table. Ananya Parikh, I'm just
ma'am,
coming.
Ananya wants to ask something. Ananya Parikh.
Yeah. Ananya, one thing, just remove all these images from your name. Yesterday also I told you the same. Second thing, whenever I'm sharing my screen, please do not raise your hands because then some words will be missed. Nitya, I'll come back to you. I'll just ask, first let me ask Ananya, he has some problem. Then I'll come to you.
Ma'am, may I drink water?
Yes, yesterday also I told you no need to take permission for drinking water. You can keep your water bottle with you. Is it clear? Only I
yes,
don't
ma'am.
Want
I have kept.
I am just saying this. I don't want anybody eating or sleeping. You can drink water. Is it clear? Ananya, just remove all these images.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Mute yourself. Nitya, I'm coming to you.
Ma'am, due to network issue, I'm not able to understand possessive adjectives.
Possessive adjectives. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
If I speak about possessive adjectives, the word possessive means belonging. Okay. Belonging or ownership. Like suppose if you say, this pen is mine. If you say, it means who is the owner of this pen? You are the owner of this pen. This is your book. So who is the owner of that book? You are the owner, the person to whom you are saying. Is it clear to you? And there are certain words which are used with singular and plural. So if you want, I can share my screen and I'll show you back. Okay, wait a minute. I'll just share. See, from here you can understand, Nitya. See, the definition is saying that these adjectives are used to point out the noun. Everywhere, wherever we are using adjectives, we are either pointing nouns or pronouns, right? Now, it is used to point out that the noun is belonging to someone. It is not compulsory that every time it is belonging to me only. It can belong to everyone, anybody. So generally there are seven, like my, your, our is used for plural. Their, his, again masculine, then her, feminine, and it or it is used for neuter. See, masculine, you know, we use for male, her we use for feminine gender. Neuter gender is a gender which is neither masculine nor feminine. It is used for generally non-living things. Now, how can we use possessive adjectives? See, like my, yours, his, her, its. They are used if the possessor. Possessor means the person who is owning the thing. If he is singular. And if the possessor is plural, then we use our. Like if I say this is our house, it means this is not only Nitya's house. The house belongs to your mother, father, grandparents, to your sister. That's why we are saying it, this is our house, your and their. Now, if the thing which is possessed, it can be singular also, it can be plural also. It doesn't matter. His is used for masculine, her is used for feminine. Generally, my, your, are, they are used for masculine and feminine. Again, it, if you are saying for singular, then you will say it. If it is for plural neuter gender, then they.